你好 ，Welcome back. Today we'll start lesson 12. 明天天气怎么样 ？You know, in the language, we always use ask about the weather to start a conversation. So today we will start some expression about weather. First one, 天气，天气 ，that means weather.If the weather is very good, we can say 天气很好。天气很好。But it's not very good, we can say 天气不好。天气不好。怎么样？怎么样？ That means how. To asking the condition of someone or something. For example, 天气怎么样？天气怎么样? Also, we can add 昨天、今天、明天 and also the place. For example, 昨天 or 今天 or 明天北京天气怎么样?北京的天气怎么样? So, 怎么样? Can alwaysMake a question. For example, 你的汉语怎么样?你的汉语怎么样? How about your Chinese? 你妈妈身体怎么样?你妈妈身体怎么样? How does your mother's body? 明天天气怎么样?明天天气怎么样? How about weather tomorrow?太 That means very, extremely. It's an adverb. It's too, very. In Chinese, we have the expression 太了 to showing a very strong emotion. You can say 好 好 That means good. So good, very good. We can say 太好了太好了Pay attention, the lower is a neutral tone. 这个学校太好了。太。Before we learned tasty, 好吃，好吃。Very tasty, very delicious, we can say 太好吃了。The whole sentence, 这个菜太好吃了。Also, you can say the negative form is 不太不太 and the 了 is omitted. For example, 这个菜不太好吃这个菜不太好吃 Pay attention without 了热热 that means hot. The opposite is 冷冷Cold. Too hot, we can say 太热了。Too cold, we can say 太冷了。If it's not too cold and not too hot, we can say 不冷不热。不冷不热。Pay attention, 不热不冷 is unacceptable. Also, we can say不大不小 neither too big nor too small. Always an adjective or be opposite.
不多不少
neither more or less.
多少
that is opposite. We have the sentence with subject and predicate phrase. You can see the structure. Subject.And the predict combined with subject and object. You can say,
我身体不太好。我身体不太好。
我 is a big subject. In the following sentence,
身体不太好。身体
is another small subject. 不太好。That is a predict.
明天天气很好。明天天气很好。
你身体怎么样？
你身体怎么样？
Also with two subjects. Here is a dialogue.
昨天北京的天气怎么样？
太热了。
明天呢？
明天天气怎么样？
明天天气很好，不冷不热。
Another expression of some weather.
下雨，下雨。
That means to rain.
下
means under, below. Before we learned, that is a noun. But with verb, it means of rain, snow, and etc. to fall. Also, snow, to snow, we can say 下雪，
下雪。
Before we learned 去，
去，
to go. The opposite is to come. That is
来，
来。So you can say 去学校，
去医院。
And to come,
来学校，
来我家。Here's a modal verb,
会，
会。To indicate the possibility of situation before we mentioned. For example,
爸爸八点前会回家吗？
会。That is a positive answer.
明天他会来吗？
Will she come tomorrow?
他会来。
他会来。
今天会下雨。
That means it may rain today, but now.
今天会下雨吗?
Here's a question with the positive answer is
会。
会。The negative answer is
不会。
不会。Here's a dialogue.
今天会下雨吗?
今天不会下雨。
王小姐今天会来吗？
不会来，天气太冷了。Another new word.
身体，
身体。That means body. To ask one's body and health condition, we can say
你身体怎么样？
你身体怎么样？ That means how are you?If you say I'm good, I can say
我身体很好。
我身体很好。Not so good, we can say
我身体不好。
我身体不好。But 我身体不很好 is a wrong expression. If you want to express, we can say
我身体不太好。
我身体不太好。To see very strong emotion, we can say
我身体很不好。
很不好。Pay attention about the order of the sentence.
爱。
爱。That means to love. We can always put a verb after it. We can say,Loving drinking tea, we can say
爱喝茶，
爱喝茶。Love study,
爱学习，
爱学习。The negative form is
不爱喝茶，
不爱学习。
些，
些 ，that means some, a few. The usually expression is
一些
to plus some noun.For example, some books, we can say
一些书，
一些书。Some friends,
一些朋友，
一些朋友。
Before we learned 这个、
那个、
哪个。
With 些
we have the plural form.
这些、那些、哪些。
Please pay attention.
水果、
水果。That means fruit. Some fruit, we can say
一些水果。
To eat some fruit, we can say
吃水果、吃水果。
With the verb 爱, we have the whole sentence.
你爱吃水果吗？你爱吃水果吗？
The positive answer is
我爱吃水果。
The negative form is
我不爱吃水果。水、
水。That means water. Drink water.
喝水、喝水。
An expression about 多 as a verb phrase and 少 as a verb phrase. We can say to drink more water.
多喝水、多喝水。
To drink less coffee.
少喝咖啡、
少喝咖啡。Also,
多读
read more,
多写
write more,
多说
speak more, and is a suggestion to for you learning Chinese. Here's a dialogue.
你身体怎么样？
我身体不太好，天气太热了，不爱吃饭。
你多吃些水果。多喝水。谢谢你，医生。
Here's some practice. With 太
了、多、爱、名字、些
and 怎么样。Try to fill the blanks with these words. First one.
北京的天气怎么样？你多喝水，天气太热了。他们不想住这儿，这儿太冷了。这个星期我身体不太好，不爱吃饭。天气很热，你多吃些水果。
Well done.We have some collection with the third tone. And we have some word.
跟我读。星期一，冰激凌。星期五，星期六，清洁工。捉迷藏。吃苹果。加拿大。高脚杯，堆雪人，花雨伞，吃米饭，哈密瓜，机器人，波浪鼓，医务室。
Also, it has three Chinese characters. First one is 天,
天,
that means the sky.
天气，天气。
So the second Chinese character is 气, that means air. Another one is called 雨,
雨,
to rain. You can see the raindrops. Pay attention about the writing order. Another two radicals. First one is called 女字旁,
女字旁。
Always related to female. For example,
妈妈、妈妈、姐姐、姐姐。
The second radical is 十字旁、
十字旁。
Always related to food. For example,
饭、饭、 that means meal, and yin, that means to drink. Try to find more Chinese characters with these two radicals, and make some practice with the word we just learned today. So much for today. Thanks for listening.
谢谢，再见。